Mani Na Budni. Welcome to Church Online, recorded on Kaurna land. My name is Lynn. I'm part of the ministry team at Adelaide West, and I'll be sharing with you today. We gather in God's love together to pray, to worship, and reflect. We light this candle, remembering that God is love. We love because God first loved us, and as we live in love, we live in God. Last week was the Redemption Youth Camp. It was a great time of community, worship, teaching, and of course, energy and enthusiasm. Thanks to everyone who supplied food or helped out financially for this important ministry. On the 25th of April, we commemorated Anzac Day, a day of national remembrance where we give thanks for those who have given their lives and to recognise more than 1.5 million men and women who have served Australia in all conflicts, wars and peacekeeping operations, lest we forget. We sing an old favourite, "To God be the glory, so loved he the world that he gave us his Son."
The reading today is from 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 to 21. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us. This is how we know that we live in him and he in us. He has given us of his Spirit, and we have seen and testify that the Father has sent his Son to be the Saviour of the world. If anyone acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God lives in them and they in God. And so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in love lives in God, and God in them. This is how love is made complete among us, so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. In this world, we are like Jesus. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We love because he first loved us. Whoever claims to love God yet hates a brother or sister is a liar. For whoever does not love their brother and sister, whom they have seen, cannot love God, whom they have not seen. And he has given us this command: anyone who loves God must also love their brother and sister. Hear the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
What we wear in every season and age is interesting. The late 1970s and 80s were certainly interesting. For a teenager, it was the age of desert boots, Levi jeans and duffel coats. I remember sewing the Levi tag on the back pocket onto the jeans so it couldn't be ripped off by someone behind me at school. And I can remember wearing a God is Love badge. I Googled it. Blue badge, God is love, and there it was. It brought back some memories. It was the size of a 10 cent piece, and I wore it to Flinders University, out shopping, to youth group and church, wherever. As I look back on my late teenager, young adult self, I wonder, what was I trying to say with this badge? Was it for identification? People would recognize me as Christian? Possibly. Probably. Was it for education, to tell people that God is the source of all love? Possibly. Probably. Was it a reminder to me to live in a way that showed God is love? Perhaps it was a bit of all of those things. And then I think about what people thought when they saw this badge. She's a Christian. That's a bit cute. Or did they roll their eyes behind my back? I don't know what people thought, and I'm not wearing that badge today. But the wording of the badge came from 1 John 4. God is love. Scholars believe the letters of John were written around 85 to 100 in the Common Era to believers in what is today Turkey. These letters are also known as epistles, which are simply letters from an apostle. They're attributed to John as they're similar in style to John's gospel. If the author isn't John, it could well be written with the intent to be like John. At the time, many Christians were experiencing a crisis of faith because of persecution and false teaching. So these letters are to encourage believers to hold on to the truth and help them persevere while others have been taken in by false teaching. That's the context. This particular passage is about love, God's love and our love. The word love is mentioned. The word love is mentioned 27 times in 15 verses. 27 times. Statistics aren't everything, but I think the author wants us to notice something about love. Clearly, love is the subject matter. We're at the heart of 1 John, and it seems this is what John most wants to say. Love is on his mind. The purpose of 1 John is to convince the hearers that God's love is known in the real life person of Jesus Christ. And he starts by saying that God's love is revealed precisely in sending Jesus, God's Son, into the world to be the sacrifice for us. And when we think of that sacrifice on the cross for all the sin and evil in our lives and in the world, it is such deep love, more than we can understand. We sense power and possibilities within that love. This is a force that has changed the world and can still change the world if we live in this love, God's love. Therefore, dear friends, or beloved in some translations, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. And to understand the depth of this verse, we need to go on. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us and his love is made complete in us. We don't really know who God is until we see Jesus, as we haven't seen God. And the author of this letter states that in the first chapter, and here in this verse, people don't really know who God is until they see God revealed in the life of Christians. His love is made complete in us. It has full expression in us. Theologian Tom Wright puts it this way: what God launched decisively in Jesus, he wants to complete in and through us as Jesus unveiled God before a surprised and unready world. So must we. Love is that important. You know, we could explore the structure of this passage at length, as it seems quite intentional. Just looking at one thing, in verse 7 we find the words A, dear friends, let us love one another. B, for love comes from God. And then in verse 11 we find it inverted. A, dear friends, since God so loved us. B, we also ought to love one another. You get the picture. John repeats himself in various ways. It's poetic, with the intention of conveying an important message about love. At the end of this passage, John repeats himself once again. Clearly, he wants us to really hear his words. If you say you love God and don't love your brother or sister, and here that means someone in the Christian community, you are telling lies. In fact, if you've experienced God's love and don't love your brother or sister in Christian community, then you don't love God. They are really strong words, challenging words. It means I need to look at my love for others in the church and by implication, others in my life. We use the word love in so many different ways, don't we? We say we love people, and some especially so, and yet we love that painting. And we love chocolate and coffee. Clearly, we don't love all these in the same way, although love is the same four letters. I read about a sign that said this: hate and rage are four-letter words, and so are hope and love. Let's choose the four-letter words that John is talking about here. We say, of course, but it's easy to talk about love and be a bit idealistic. What does this practically mean for us? It's showing compassion that is real and authentic, practical compassion wherever possible, helping those who are doing it tough, meals, providing food, inviting someone for a meal, taking someone out for coffee, watching a movie with someone who's feeling lonely. It means being kind, really kind, out of the way kind. It's not agreeing or joining in when someone talks negatively about someone else, even defending the person being talked about. I wrote an acrostic. It's rather basic. Love is showing compassion and being very kind to everyone at church, in the community, our families, at work, school, community groups. It's rather simple. L for love is. O for showing compassion. V for being very kind. And E for everyone. And I hope it helps us to remember some aspects about love. Now, some of you may be wordsmiths. I wonder if we could gather a few acrostics using the word love. I would love to share some others next week. They can be simple like mine or using longer, fancier words. Send them to churchonline@awuc.au. Love is including people. Inclusion isn't just inviting someone to sit at your table, it's believing that they belong there. We live well together when we live in love, laying down our lives for each other, giving of the more than enough that we have for those who have less than enough. When we live together in this way, we are living in God and we are letting God live in us. It appears that this was written, that this is what Christian community can be. After all, a Christian community has this constant state of affairs that needs work. But the church can be the visible evidence that a better world is possible. I believe this passionately. Those who love live in love. Live in God, and God lives in them because God is love. This passage is meditative and contemplative. Be washed over with this language. Can I encourage you to read this passage this week or in the coming days? If you can, read it several times. Read it using the spiritual practice of Lectio Divina. Read it, preferably out loud. Read again and meditate. Read and pray and then contemplate. We explored Lectio Divina in the 18th of February service, Out of the Wilderness, Take a Map. As you read it, allow the words to wash over you. Hear the poetry, the style. Notice the repetition. Perhaps learn a verse or two. Don't miss the point. Let us love one another, for love comes from God. We love because God first loved us. Some have referred to this as the gospel in just a few words. We are called to love. Our love in action is participating in God's mission, in the movement of God towards people as led by Jesus. And God's perfect love drives away any fear. All we need is love, God's love. As we live in God's love and love one another, others will see God's love. And that's the badge we wear today, showing God is love. I'm going to finish with a poem, a litany, adapted from Catherine Hawker. God calls us to a ministry of love. Beloved, let us love one another. We are called to love our parents and our children, our friends and our neighbours. Love is from God. We are called to love the neighbour that hurt our feelings, the parent who was cruel, and the co-worker who is selfish. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. We are called to love even the people we cannot see, in countries near and far, in places of war and unrest, in the faraway or hidden places of our own nation. Those who love God must love their sisters and brothers also. May we accept God's call to this mysterious ministry. Amen.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Oh, Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, let me bring your light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Part of our loving others is praying for others. Let's pause to pray. God of love, thank you for your deep, deep love for us. We come to you as a source of all love. Thank you that you live in us, that you are love. We're sorry for those times that we don't recognize your love for us, when we don't look to live in you. We don't love our brothers and sisters. Thank you that these things and all our sin is forgiven through your love for us on the cross. Holy Spirit, help us to be a people of love, real, authentic love. God of love, let love be shown to all your creation, to people and places that we know and love, and those that we do not. Encourage us to show your love even in spaces we find difficult. God of peace, go where there is little or none. Be the glimmer of hope so desperately needed. Let those in times and places of war know we still pray for them. When peace is too far away, we pray for moments of joy, fleeting or lasting. Give strength to all in times of darkness. Support them as they seek to keep their light shining. We pray especially for those leaders who set examples of behaviour, for teachers who need more time, for politicians who need more understanding. We ask, God, that your love may be shown through peace from war, judgment, poverty, pain, peace from trying to control that which we cannot. Lord God, we all have people on our hearts today. We want to lift them to you in this moment and pray that your love would swirl around them, carry them, be with them, walk beside them, and alongside them, behind them. We lift them to you now. God, remind us today of the love and acceptance shown to us by your Son, Jesus. Help us to be more Christ-like in our actions and in inactions, supporting others, accepting the differences that we like and don't, and loving to the best of our ability, just as Jesus did. And just as Jesus gave of himself, so we bring our offerings to you. They're small in comparison, but we bring what we can financially and also practically. and pray that they will be used wisely to show your love to the world. We lift to you our prayers, those prayed aloud, those in our hearts, together in the name of Jesus. Amen.
We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, and we pray that all unity may one day be restored, and they'll know we are Christians by our love, they'll know we are Christians by our love. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand. Together we'll spread the news that God is in our land. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, they'll know we are Christians by our love. We will work with each other, we will work side by side. We will work with each other, we will work side by side. And we'll guard each other's dignity and save each other's pride. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, they'll know we are Christians by our love. Praise to the Father from whom all things come, and all praise to Christ Jesus, his only Son, and all praise to the Spirit who makes us one. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.
Thank you for joining us today. We hope that this service has brought you love and hope. If you would like prayer or pastoral care, please reach out to us by text or email. We would love to pray with you and for you. This week, may you know God's love deeply, and as love comes from God, living God's love, showing love to others in compassion and kindness in the coming days. And now, may the grace and the kindness of our Lord Jesus Christ, the deep love of God, and the friendship of the Holy Spirit be with you now, be with you tomorrow, remain with you always as you seek to love God and to love others. Amen.
Now we are Christians by our love. All praise to the Father from whom all things come, and all praise to Christ Jesus, his only Son, and all praise to the Spirit who makes us one. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.